Okay, so our bell ringer today, what do you like or dislike about your portrait drawing? I know that we talked about this project, what y'all are enjoying about this project, what you dislike. Talked about the time that it's taking you to draw with something that y'all were not too fond of. But how about your actual drawing? How is it looking? What is your favorite thing that you have drawn? It may be that the hair, the texture in the hair is looking really nice, but maybe you're having trouble with working on some of the facial features, or vice versa. So someone raise your hand and tell me something that you think looks really good in your drawing.
Jakeetha?
My hair.
The hair looks nice. I agree. That highlight in your hair looks very nice, so you can see where the light source is coming. What about you, Fallon?
My eyes look the best.
Your eyes look the best, okay? And you know, that's funny. Wasn't that the one part of your drawing that you were most concerned with?
Yes.
You were most worried about the eyes, but in the end, that is what is looking the best, okay? Excellent. What about you, Mariah?
I like the texture on my hands.
The texture that you created on the hands. I agree. It looks very nice. You should all be impressed with yourself because the portraits are coming out really nice. So Friday we took a little break from this project and most of y'all were on the field trip with me, so we got to have some fun before our long weekend. So let's review what tools we are using and how they're helping us. So someone tell me, what is this viewfinder doing? Cameron?
It helps you focus on each section of the portrait.
Exactly. It helps you focus on one small section of your drawing at a time. What about the tortillion? What is that?
It helps you shade the blends in with the outside.
Okay, so it helps you to blend and smooth out your pencil lines. And what about the kneaded eraser?
For highlights.
Helps you to create highlights, okay? So I'm gonna walk around and just keep double checking your work as you're working on it. Yes, Nick? A pencil, of course. I have the number two pencils right there and the drawing pencils are on the table. Has anyone got about maybe halfway done with your project so far? Kind of about halfway. Okay, so I'm going to walk around individually and we will look at your portrait together and just see if there are small things that you need to adjust. Yes, sir?
I can't take this one.
I would rather you work on this in class. I will give you the rest of this week and I'll probably give you some time next week if we still need an extra day or two. Let's see how far you've got on Friday and then make a decision about whether you should bring it home or not. Okay.
You have highlights, that looks nice.
And I would just, so you don't have to go back at the end and do this, I would kind of add a very light value for your skin. Of course, it's going to be lighter than your hair in the background. But go ahead and do that. It's going to complete what you have done so far quite a bit. Kind of make it look more finished. And then be careful to look at these shadows. Because of your hair across your eye. I guess those shadows right there.
I think
this together.
This is B.
Oh, this is B.
The shape looks really nice. The lips, I would even lighten just a little bit more right there with your kneaded eraser and look for that highlight that is on the corner of his jacket.
All right.
This looking very nice.
Do the drawing pencils help quite a bit to get the right, the right value? A lot easier than just the number two pencil. Jakeetha, aren't you glad that you paid your art fee? So how are you creating that texture for her head scarf?
Well, I'm trying to go as with it. Like, it looks like it's like double crossing, like kind of like a pattern, like a hatch pattern.
So I'm trying to make it look like hatching to draw lines that are crossing. Well, it looks good because you can tell that that is not her hair, that it is something wrapped around her head. Shante, what do you think about these drawing pencils? Is it helping you to get the correct values?
Oh, yeah. People like really more texture.
Viewfinder so that you can focus on one small piece of this picture. Project. Does anyone think that in the future you would like to try drawing another portrait one day?
Yes, ma'am.
Raise your hand if you would like to draw another portrait one day in the future. Raise your hand if this is good for you. You're done. No more portrait drawing.
I might be
out. When I first did a grid portrait, I was also intimidated. But using the grid technique, I found it made it a lot easier for me. So then I wasn't so worried the next time I had to draw a portrait. Just be careful, focus on where do you see the white part of her eye and make sure that that stays a part of her eyelid. Has anyone noticed their grid kind of disappearing as you draw? Or is it still really...
Mine disappeared.
So it's kind of blending in with your drawing, whatever pencil marks you're putting down. Good. At the end, you don't want to see your grid. That's why we drew it very lightly on your drawing paper, so that eventually it'll disappear. And then you will erase the grid from the background. So what are you using the 4H pencil for, Bria?
To make it lighter.
To draw the light
what
area?
The lightest value is.
You're pretty impressed with yourself?
Sort of, kinda.
It's better
than last year.
A big improvement since last year, don't you think? Do you think that it was all the practice, or do you think you enjoy
art more?
I think
it's the drawing pencils, kind of.
The tools pencil that you're using?
This one's, I couldn't do it. Like, it was too much, like, the pressure, the pain, and then it was getting aggravating, and then it gets stressful. But with this, you could just find the shape and the value.
So with the right tools, that makes a big difference, huh?
Yes, ma'am. Oh, my goodness.
Oh, my goodness. You got that. Look at, first, look at your corner. And fill in that shadow.
I can do my ear.
And then, yes, exactly. I'm going to use the tortillon to blend that out a little. Now, let's look at where this line falls. So this is about the center of the square. So it's about in the middle. Has anyone else used their viewfinder to help you measure something? It works as a great tool to measure the placement of something as well. Focus on the value and don't worry about trying to draw the shape. Even though you know that that is the corner of the mouth, focus on the values you see instead of drawing what you would think of whenever you see the mouth. Remember, focus on the values that you're looking at in your reference photo. If you get too hung up on the idea of this is an ear, I have to make this look just like an ear, it's only going to confuse yourself. Rather than focusing on the correct values, you'll end up with the right shape.
I think this is probably the best project you've ever done, huh?
Yeah.
Do you think you would have done as good of a job on this project if we had not already practiced creating value scales?
No, ma'am.
Why not, Nick?
For like the shading, like to get like try to get the correct shading, would be like harder.
It would be harder to
like see like the dark areas and the light areas.
Like to recognize the difference between them.
Because before they probably.
You just think of it as like gray. Okay. But after doing the value scale, you can see that there is a wide range between the white and black.
I made a lot
easier.
Yes, ma'am.
I think one of the boxes mixed up a 6D or a 3D.
Yes, it's probably in that other box of pencils. Yeah.
So we have to have.
Okay,
I'll show you. I think it should do the job.
Okay. Here it goes.
Here goes nothing.
So what part of your picture is your favorite so far?
I think the eyes is gonna be my favorite. Then, well, the suit probably is my favorite because I didn't think I could do it at first, but I just really did it.
Okay.
So I think the suit.
So you weren't too sure about that, but it ended up looking pretty nice.
Yeah, it ended up coming out good.
I think so too. Okay, so someone tell me, if you could start over on this project, what would you change about your drawing?
The mouth.
The person.
The mouth?
The mouth.
Why? You're having a hard time with the shape or the value?
The shape.
The shape?
My nose.
The nose?
Yeah.
What?
The shape.
The shape, okay. Anyone else, if you could change something about your project and go back?
A different person.
You might choose a different reference photo.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. And how about something you're really proud of that you think looks really nice? What about you, Mariah? What is something that you think looks really nice? The hand and the lips. And what about you, Shantae?
The eyes,
but
I don't like the lips. It's like not proportional.
Okay, so the eyes you think came out really nice, but you're having trouble working on the lips.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, we still have a few days to complete this project, so we have time to correct things that we are unhappy with.
Yeah, that's what you guys are seeing.